Now, very good morning to students of standard 6th. We are just doing the revision of chapter number 9, that is the living organism characteristics and habitats. Now, in that we have seen the different habitats. We have completed till different habitats. In that also desert is completed, and the desert is completed. Now, to see the things, forward that was remaining in our 9.3, that were grassland, one is aquatic and one is ponds and lake. Now, these are the different habitats. We have just completed two habitats, that is one is desert and one is mountain. So, we have seen many things, or we can say we have seen the animals and the plants which are grown in these regions. They are different from each other because of the environment present there. The environment that is present in mountains, or we can say the environment which is present near a grassland, both are having a different environment. So there the variety of plants are growing in these two places are different from each other. Now we have seen the animals which are living in desert and the animals which are living on a grassland, both have the qualities difference in them. One has to store more water because there is less or the scarcity of water in the desert, and in grassland you can get the water when you are roaming here and there, you can get a water very easily. So there is no storage capacity in the animals, there is a less storage capacity in the animals. So these are the difference between the animals and the plants which are living in a different habitats. Now third one is our grassland. In a grassland, if you see there, many wild animals live in a grassland areas. Now if you take an example of a lion and a deer, then both the animals having the same color, much of the same color, you can say this our lion has a light brown color and somewhat golden color, or we can say like that also. And the deer also has a both colors, a white color also it includes and the golden color, or we can say the brown color. So these animals are different, they are living on a one place but they are having a different size and shape and color. One thing is to notice there is that lion has two eyes on the mouth, or we can say on the face, and the deer has its two eyes side on its side, on the head of the side. Now why the eyes of a lion and the eyes of a deer are different? If you want to say that, because a lion has a capability of preying the animals. They have a jaws, a powerful jaws is there. And they can also withdraw it inside the toe. That jaws can be withdrawn, means they are inside their toes. के जो टो उसका होता है तो उसके पीछे उसका जोश होता है. जोश मीन्स उसका पंजा. जब वो पंजा मारता है तो किसी भी प्राणी का वो बोन से वो क्रैक कर देता है, इतना फोर्स उसके पंजे में होता है. और द हैविंग दैट मच फोर्स इन इट जोस व्हेन इट्स प्रेइंग द एनिमल्स, एंड आफ्टर दैट दे जस्ट कैच देयर नेक एंड दे विल नॉट लीव दैट नेक अंटिल द एनिमल इज डेड. दैट इज द वे ऑफ प्रेइंग द दैट इज द वे ऑफ अ लायन टू प्रे एनी एनिमल. दैट इज अ टेक्निक, इट इज गिवन टू द लायन. In a grassland areas, you can find many trees also, different types of trees, which is having or which needs water. frequently we can say, not the plants like which are growing in the desert. They are not having, means there is scarcity of water there, so the plants are also grown in a such a manner that they will need less amount of water. In a grassland area, the trees which are growing in a grassland areas, they will need more water because they are just staying in between the grassland area and the water resources also sometimes. Okay, so we were talking about the lion and the deer. If we take these two examples only of the grassland areas of the animals, then they are also having the different shape and size and color. Now, if we talk about the deer, then what happens to deer? Now, deer is very thin, it has a long legs, okay, it has a big ears, and their eyes are on the side of the head. Why the eyes are on the side of the heads? Because they can notify the predators that is coming nearby them. Now, predators means the animals who prey them. Now, prey them means the animals which are dangerous to them. We can say that also, that animals include lion, tiger, okay, wolves and all these things, okay. So these animals are endangered to the deer, so they are having their eyes on the side to notify whether any harmful animal is there nearby it or not. If they are having eyes in front, means on the face, then they cannot look around, they cannot look surrounding, okay. To look in and each and every direction by standing only, they are having the eyes on their head, on a side, so they can look very broad. Their ears are very sharp because if the lion is coming to hunt it, so they can hear the noise from long distance. That is a God gifted to the deers. And their legs are very thin, so they can run very fast also. So these are the characteristics of the animals which are living in grassland. Okay, ये सब जो animals है वो grassland में है, तो grassland में क्या, grassland में सब animals predators नहीं होते, या सब animals है वो preying वाले भी नहीं होते, शिकारी भी नहीं होते. तो जो प्राणी के जो animals है तो उसके बीच में भी difference होते हैं, mainly difference according to their characteristics, they are different from each other. Now the plants which are grown here are not grown in the desert, that we know. We cannot grow a mango tree in the desert because it needs water, plenty of water, okay. We cannot grow the coconut tree in the desert because they need the plenty of water, that's why. So this plants are grown on the grassland where there is a more amount of water. And we have just talked about the lion and the deer. Now there is an aquatic. Okay. Now, what do we mean by aquatic? Means the water. The animals and plants which are living under the water. What is the main characteristics of both of these plants and animals? Jo prani पानी के अंदर रहता है और जो प्लांट्स है जो पानी के अंदर है, उसकी मेन कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स क्या है कि दे कैन ब्रीथ और दे कैन टेक द ऑक्सीजन दैट इज डिजोल्व्ड इन द वाटर. जो पानी के अंदर जो ऑक्सीजन डिजोल्व होता है उसको वो ब्रीथ करते हैं. वो दैट इज अ मेन कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ द एनिमल्स एंड द प्लांट्स विच आर लिविंग अंडर द वाटर. Under the water, the aquatic animals are there and the aquatic plants are also there. If we take an example of a fish, then fish has a streamlined body shape. This is known as a streamlined body shape. Okay. Streamlined body shape. If we take an example of an octopus, or we can say a starfish also. Okay, but they are not having a streamlined body shape. Starfish होती है वो स्टार के हिसाब से होती है. ओके, दिस इज आवर स्टारफिश. नाउ स्टारफिश इज नॉट लाइक अ स्ट्रीम लाइक अ फिश और अ स्ट्रीमलाइन बॉडी शेप. इट इज नॉट द बट व्हेन इट स्विम्स इन अ वॉटर इट मेक्स इट्स बॉडी लाइक अ इट्स मेक्स इट बॉडी लाइक अ स्ट्रीम लाइक शेप. इफ यू टॉक अबाउट अ octopus, octopus is having how many legs? 8. That's why its name is octopus. Okay, when the octopus is having okay, this is octopus. When the octopus is steady in the water, its body shape is not streamlined. Okay, its body is not a streamlined, but when it swims its body gets into streamlined shape. Okay, how does it will be look when it swims? At that time you have seen in the movies and all these things, okay, or in Animal Planet, this is octopus. Okay, then its body will become to streamlined shape. Like a cone, okay, it will move streamlined shape. So why the body is streamlined? Why the body is streamlined? The body is streamlined because they can cut the water very fast, or we can say in a easily way. That's why our plane shape is jo hamare hawai jahaz hai na, to uska shape bhi फिश जैसा ही है. दे गेट द आइडिया ऑफ अ प्लेन हाउ टू शेप अ प्लेन दैट इज फ्लाइंग. दे गोट एन आइडिया फ्रॉम दिस फिश ओनली. सो दे कैन कट द एयर वेरी फास्ट एंड मूव स्टेडी इन द एयर. नाउ दिस एक्वेटिक एनिमल्स आर देयर. दे आर हैविंग अ स्ट्रीमलाइन शेप. दे कैन स्विम वेरी फास्ट इन द वॉटर. दे आर ऑल्सो हैविंग द गिल्स. ओके, गिल्स आर प्रेजेंट where our ears are there. In the fish there are gills are present. Okay, okay, I have drawn these gills here. So what is the main work of this? It is the main work of this gill is to respire. Okay, what do you mean by the respire? Means it take the oxygen that is dissolved in the water by the gills. Okay, this is the main function of the gills that is present in the fishes. Okay, now if we talk about the dolphins and the whales, they don't have the gills present in them to breathe. They have a blow holes, means a two big holes on their head, on the upper side of their head. That's why they swim under the water but near the surface of the water. Wo kahan pe swim karte hai ye whales or dolphins? Yahan pe wo स्विम करते हैं. नियर द सर्फेस ऑफ द वॉटर दे स्विम्स बिकॉज दे कैन इजिली गेट द एयर फ्रॉम द एनवायरमेंट. दे कैन ब्रीथ इजिली फ्रॉम द एनवायरमेंट. जब आप डॉल्फिन्स देखते हैं ना, तो डॉल्फिन्स कभी कभी क्या करती है, जंप लगाती है. क्यों वो हवा में जंप लगाती है पानी में से बाहर निकल के? क्योंकि उसको ब्रीथ करना पड़ता है, इसलिए वो जंप्स लगाती है. दे कैन स्टे विदाउट ब्रीथिंग इन द वॉटर फॉर अ लॉन्ग टाइम. But when they are required to, when they required to take the oxygen, at that time they move up on the near to the surface of the water wells, and they are breathing. Or dolphins are just jumping, okay, dolphins are just jumping over the sea, we can say, on the surface of the water, and they are just taking the breath, or they are just breathing like this way. So these are the characteristics of the aquatic animals. Now the characteristics of the plants which are under the water. If we talk about the ponds and lakes or a river or a aquatic plants, then what is the shape of a plant? उसके roots कैसे है, उसके leaves कैसे है, ये सब हमें aquatic और we can say aquatic plants में हमें दिखने को मिलता है. और उसमें एक बात कहे तो उसमें जो roots है वो बहुत short है. उसका काम क्या है कि उसको एक प्लांट को सिर्फ स्टेडी रखना उसका काम होता है, इसलिए उसका जो रूट्स है वो कम साइज में है, शॉर्ट वी कैन से. देयर वर्क इज टू मेंटेन और देयर वर्क इज टू होल्ड द प्लांट, उसको सिर्फ एक जगह पे होल्ड करना ही उसका काम होता है पानी में. और ज़्यादातर जो प्लांट्स होते हैं पानी में और पानी के ऊपर जो प्लांट्स ग्रो करते हैं, इफ यू टेक एन एग्जांपल ऑफ अ लोटस, ओके, सो देयर रूट्स आर अंडर द लोटस, का जो रूट्स है तो वो पानी के अंदर होते हैं. ये पानी है हमारा, उसके रूट्स यहाँ पे होते हैं लोटस के, फिर यहाँ पे ये लोटस होता है हमारा, ओके, ये हमारा लोटस होता है, फूल है, और उसके लीव्स भी होते हैं, ओके, दिस टू आर द लीव्स. सो व्हाट डू वी से दैट, व्हाट आई वांट टू से दैट, देयर प्लांट्स आर हैविंग वेरी शॉर्ट रूट्स. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल दे आर हैविंग वेरी शॉर्ट रूट्स, ओके. सेकेंड थिंग, देयर फ्लावर्स एंड द लीव्स, flowers and leaves float on water, float on water, okay. These two are the characteristics of the plants. Now the water, then now the water and the plant, and some plants are also grown inside the water also, and these प्लांट्स आर हैविंग लॉन्ग स्टेम. स्टेम उसका कितना होता है, लॉन्ग होता है स्टेम, और होलो होता है, होलो. होलो मीन्स के जो स्टेम है उसका, उसके अंदर एक होल होता है, पोरस टाइप का उसका होता है, उसके अंदर कुछ होता नहीं है स्टेम के अंदर, सिर्फ स्टेम है और अंदर में सब कुछ खाली रहता है, होलो टाइप स्टेम. They are heavy. So these are the characteristics of the plant which is grown in ponds or lakes or a river. Now some animal, some we can say some plants are grown inside the water also. So they are having narrow and thin ribbon like leaves. Okay. Now some plants which are under the water, they are having very thin leaves, or some are divided very highly, or some leaves are highly divided. के जो leaves है उसकी वो cut होती है बीच में से, वो सारे बहुत सारे cut होते हैं, small small leaf strips we can see. If I will show you, then you may get what is the leaves that is present in the water, the plants which are present in the water having a stream like, they are having the stream like leaves, okay. If this plant is, this plant is under the water, okay, then they are having a stream like leaves, okay, ye iske leaves hote hain.
ओके, ये क्या है लीव्स।
तो ऐसे डिवाइडेड लीव्स, एक पूरा लीव्स क्यों नहीं होता? हमारा जो ट्रीज यहाँ पे जो ग्रासलैंड में जो ट्रीज जो हमें दिखने को मिलता है तो उसके लीव्स इस तरह के होते हैं। ओके, उसका लीव्स इस तरह एक पूरा लीव्स होता है, पर यहाँ पे तो जो लीव्स है वो डिवाइडेड है और स्मॉल स्मॉल स्ट्रिप्स की तरह होते हैं। तो उसका क्या इम्पोर्टेंस है पानी के अंदर, इस तरह के लीव्स क्यों होते हैं? तो ये जब पानी फ्लो होता है तो पानी इसमें से तुरंत निकल जाता है। ओके, दैट्स व्हाई दे आर हैविंग, दैट्स व्हाई दे आर हैविंग अ स्ट्रिप लाइक लीव्स। ओके, देन सम लीव्स और दे जो इसका जो ये स्टेम है ना, तो वो बहुत फ्लेक्सिबल होता है। जब पानी इधर से आता है कोई एक इस डायरेक्शन में अगर पानी फ्लो होता है तो उस तरफ बेंड हो जाता है, फिर खड़ा हो जाता है वो प्लांट। बाद में अगर वेस्ट साइड से पानी बहुत ज़्यादा आता है, फ्लो होता है, तो वो वेस्ट वो इस साइड तरफ मुड़ जाता है और खड़ा हो जाता है। अगर इस साइड से आता है तो वेस्ट साइड वो वेस्ट साइड से वो नम जाता है, तो वो क्या करता है आफ्टर फ्लोइंग द वाटर वो फिर से खड़ा हो जाता है। सो वी कैन से दैट द प्लांट्स विच आर अंडर द वॉटर हैविंग अ फ्लेक्सीबिलिटी इन देयर स्टेम, दे आर हैविंग अ स्ट्रिप लाइक लीव्स, दे आर हैविंग अ नैरो और वी कैन से नीडल टाइप लीव्स। ओके, सो दीज आर द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ द प्लांट्स अंडर द वॉटर एंड अबव द वॉटर। नाउ इफ यू सी, इफ यू टेक एन एग्जाम्पल ऑफ अ फ्रॉग विच इज लिविंग ऑन द लैंड एंड इन द वॉटर ऑल्सो। नाउ वॉट इज द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ दैट एनिमल, or we can say a frog has a strong legs, their jo leg jo piche ke jo do rear legs hote hai na to wo bahut strong hota hai, and jo uska jo panja hota hai ke jo piche ka aur aage ka jo charo legs hai uska jo panja hota hai to wo ek dusre se connected hote hai। ओके, अगर हम मान ले कि ये फ्रॉग का फिट है, ये फिट है, ये उसका जो फिंगर्स है वो हम ड्रॉ करते हैं, और जो दो फिंगर्स हमारी होती है उसमें हमें गैप देखने को मिलता है, पर उसके यहाँ पे गैप नहीं होता, एक स्मॉल थिन स्किन इज प्रेजेंट इन बिटवीन दिस टू, सो दे कैन स्विम वेरी इजिली। So this is the characteristics of the frog. They are having a very good strong legs. Their back two legs are very strong to catch the prey. To catch the prey or to hold the prey. Their fingers are of a webbing. Webbing means they are having a small skin or a thin skin in between two fingers. So they can swim very fast and quickly. Okay, so these are the characteristics of the animals and the plants which are living inside the water. Now you can also make the list of the plants and animals which are living in water and living on the water and living outside of the water. Now we have just completed 4 to 5 points. In 9.3, first one was desert, then mountains, then third one is grassland. Today we have seen aquatic also and ponds and lakes. Okay, so these are the points, or we can say these are the habitats, different types of habitats and the plants and animals which are living in these habitats, in these different types of habitats. Okay students, now you should go through the points of a 9.3, all the points, and if you have any questions then you can ask to me. Till that you can also take a screenshot of this for the points to remember also, and I will give you homework in the video when I will send this, when I will upload this video. At that time I will give the homework regarding these points only, 9.3. okay, thank you students, have a good day, eat healthy and stay healthy. Thank you students once again. Thank you.